Hey everybody, it's Jeff Lafferty, and it's time for another ARTCAST. This one's number 44, and it's Tuesday probably for you guys. And just finishing up this another Planet of the Apes piece. I figured I better get it out of my system before the movie goes away. So that's what I'm doing. Kind of a weird one. Really debated. It's so hot in here, actually, that everything is kind of sticking to me.
Just horrible to say, but I had to turn the fan off
to record the show, and it's just everything wanting to stick to me because I'm like a little bit sweaty. But yeah. Anyway, this one's a little bizarre. I don't know. Printed out the reference for this like last week, and I was going to do it, and then I was like, I don't know, does anybody really want to see this, but it's just like such an iconic shot from the movie. If you're like a fan of the movie, you know, you totally know this scene, and yeah, I decided to go for it, and now, like, once, just as soon as I did the sketch, I was like, oh yeah, this is going to be cool, so. I'm glad I did it, but anyway, I just drop it in the whites. Right before this, I'm recording during the afternoon. This one doesn't actually have a ton of white on it, so I'm trying to be very sparse. Sometimes I think a lot of, you know, like I noticed some guys kind of starting this kind of style and stuff with the gray paper and the blacks and all that. And I think one of the big, mistakes I kind of see is too much white. They kind of do all their blacks and draw it, which is like a lot more you know, involved process, because you're getting the whole piece down. But then when they come back with their whites, they kind of draw it all in white, you know. So they kind of come down here and they're doing whites on like her sleeve and all the whites on his hand, and you know, there's just probably not going to be much more than just the super highlight light, you know. That's kind of what I like to do. I still probably take it more than some people would. I think some people would just be like, you know, there's like a light here and, you know, maybe just tips on her eyebrows and that's probably it. I like a little bit more than that, but not too much though. You don't want to overkill it. I'll work it to death. I just got done, like I said, I'm recording this in the afternoon. So I just got done doing kind of like a big push on social media and everything for the Boba Fett piece. I don't know if you guys saw me on there listing like a crazy man, but I don't know, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. The thing was sitting at like $66 and two bids or something all week. And I was like, man, I just don't want to see it go for $60, you know, it's just not enough. For a painting, in my opinion. So got on there, asked a lot of people to share it, and I totally appreciate like everybody who did, because there was a ton of them. I think I got like, I don't know how many actually. I just got done doing it, so there was at least 20 when I came over here to finish this piece up. So I don't know what it'll be like when I get back online and see what it all ends up. I like to kind of do all that kind of stuff. I like to promote and stuff, but then I just, you know, I like to just kind of forget about what I have on eBay and stuff. And I don't know if that's a good thing or bad, but just to, you know, because it'll just drive you crazy. It's like checking your stats or something, you know. It's just like, it's going to be what it's going to be. Sometimes it's going to work, sometimes it's not. And you know, the best thing you can do is just draw another cool piece and that kind of stuff. So I do appreciate just all the help, though. And the ArtCasters group is rocking now. It seems to have, like, just immediately taken a life of its own on. And, lots of people joining. Everybody's welcome. kind of went around YouTube, and I invited a few more artists. I know that not everybody's got time for this stuff, but I don't know if you want to talk to somebody else that's into doing the same kind of stuff that you are. It's probably going to be a pretty cool place to hang out, so. There's some, like, freaking awesome artists on there already. Travis Cakos is on there. Dave Gaskin, Mark Ratz, Darren Beadman, Sid Airbrush. I'm going to call him Sid Airbrush because he's got a tough last name to pronounce. But just a lot of people, and they're all kind of just talking and sharing tips and talking about things like eBay. Andrew, I don't know what his last name is. Guy with the other Planet of the Apes stuff on eBay is on there. And he's all talking about, you know, how to sell stuff. And I noticed, like, in the comments, they were talking about Andrew's Planet of the Apes piece and it not selling. And I think Dave Gaskin was on there saying, you know, he noticed that it was U.S. only. Because I think Dave lives overseas. Actually, I know he does, from his accent. His cool James Bond accent. But I was just going to chime in here. I'll probably post it on there too. But that's something that is actually huge for me right now, is overseas. So, you know, like I think I list on my auctions, you know, that shipping over to Canada is like 12 or 8 bucks, I think I have it at. And then like overseas is like 12 or 14, which is like outrageous. But that's actually what it costs to ship, you know. So I used to do free shipping worldwide, and that was awesome. But I think I've talked about this before on here. The post office, you know, can't do its books right, so they were going to go out of business again, and they had to raise postage, and they raised, you know, the stamps or whatever. But what they didn't really tell everybody was they raised the hell out of overseas shipping. So now overseas shipping is like crazy expensive. So, but back to the point though, is it's just like, even though it's expensive, and like when I first did that, like all of it dropped off. I lost all my international customers for a while, but now I've noticed they come back, and now I'm selling, I don't know if it's half, but it's, I bet it's close to half international. So I know there's like a button when you put your auctions up. It says something like UK visibility or something. I think it just puts it on that puts it on like the UK version of eBay maybe or something. And I always click that thing. It costs like an extra 20 cents or something, but it's well worth it. Or at least it seems to work for me. I don't know. You never know what really works, you know. I think Dave was also saying, because he does like sketch cards and does videos and stuff. I'll put links for everybody I'm talking about in the show notes if you guys want to go and research some of the stuff. But he said that he thought that, what he does is he puts them all up like at the end of the month. I think like in kind of like one big mass buying thing, you know. And I don't know if that's smart or not. I remember I was going to check those out when I first kind of heard about that, and I was just watching Dave on DeviantArt, and I ended up missing it. And I don't know. But anyway, that's how he does it, and he said that he thought that most of the traffic that he sent to eBay came from, you know, links in social media and stuff, probably on DA and all that kind of stuff. But he was like, most of it. There wasn't a lot of organic traffic from eBay, and you know, that is true. Because like when I first started sticking cards up a long time ago, you know, man, I'd get nothing out of eBay. I'd get like, you know, I mean, shoot, if I didn't do any promotion, I'd get like 5 hits on an auction, you know. But as you sell on there, you know, eBay gets in your corner a little bit. Not that they even notice what you're doing, but I think it's just the algorithms of the site start to pick up on what's getting hit. I know once I became like an eBay affiliate, which I've talked about this in different shows. I don't know where to send you guys to hear about it, but actually there's a podcast I think where I explained it. I think it's like just the affiliate marketing or something. But I am an eBay affiliate, and I think I've talked about it on the show before. Anybody can sign up, and it works just like a normal affiliate program, you know, where you send traffic to wherever, and they pay you a commission on things that get sold. And some of them pay for traffic and things like that. And I don't know. I've tried affiliate marketing forever because, you know, I hear about it and I'm like, yeah, that sounds great. I'd love some free money, you know, for doing nothing. But the only one that I've ever got to work for me is the eBay affiliate program. And I love it because it's like I send so much traffic there anyway. You know, and those people that go, that click through my links, they shop. Not only my cards, they shop other people's cards and things like that. And I get definitely, you know, it's worth doing every month. It definitely pays my eBay fees and more. But what the other value, you know, I mean, that's why I did it, because I thought, yeah, you know, I'll make some commissions off that just because of the people, you know, the collectors that buy my stuff, they could buy other people's stuff too. But the real benefit that I've seen is it gives me a little bit more of a clue from like the analytics in the affiliate program as to where the traffic's coming from and stuff and what exactly is happening and where people are buying stuff. Because you can't tell everything about it. You can't tell where everybody came from. But it's a lot easier to see kind of what's happening there and kind of like the way people are circling around your auctions and what they're doing just by what comes up as a sale and what doesn't. Because, you know, even though sometimes it'll be a person that knows you, one of your fans want to buy one of your piece, they'll follow in a different link. They'll come in through, so I want to find a piece of paper real quick. I guess this will work. But they'll come in through a different link. They'll come in through, like, you know, you can follow people on eBay. Some of them will be doing that, so they'll get like an email notification that a new piece is up, and that's the way they come in and buy your stuff. And I don't know. Maybe some people just go straight to eBay and check, and then there's also the people that are in eBay looking for whatever. I mean, I always use this one card as an example I did a long time ago. It was like right when I started doing cards and didn't know much and just did one because I thought it was a neat image and was for fun, and plus it was a real nostalgia thing for me, and it was this Lone Ranger card that I did. And I drew it because me and my dad used to watch The Lone Ranger, or I would pretty much watch it. My dad would be getting ready for work, but it's kind of funny because I'd do the same thing that my son did with me when I was going to work. I would get up when he was getting ready, and I always thought he woke me up, but I bet that what was happening was I probably just got up, and he would, you know, give me breakfast and turn on the TV, and I'd watch The Lone Ranger, and then he'd go to work, and I'd go back to bed. And I used to always think that he got me up and like we'd go watch it and then he'd go to work and I'd go to bed. But I think actually what happened now, since I'm a parent and I see, you know, same thing happened with my son, is I think that I was just kind of wandering out there and he was like, here, watch Lone Ranger while I get ready. But anyway, he was, you know, my dad the cowboy and stuff. He wanted, you know, he loved that kind of stuff. So, that was like one of our favorite shows when I was a kid. And so anyway, I did this Lone Ranger sketch card, which it's like that's not anything that anybody in the sketch card market's gonna want. And it just to me makes no sense to really paint that, because nobody's gonna find it, you know. Who's looking for the Lone Ranger? There wasn't a Lone Ranger movie at the time, and it just was like kind of out of the public conscience, I guess. You know, nobody was talking about it. And I put it up, and the thing sold like almost immediately, like after a couple days. And it sold, you know, for the buy it now price. I don't know what it was, but it was a high price. And I was like, whoa. And the bid had like four or five hits on it. And I was like, I don't understand how that happened, you know? Because it wasn't like at that time I had maybe three buyers that I knew. And it wasn't any of them. So I was just kind of really perplexed as to what the heck happened, you know? And I'm thinking, I don't know if I should. I was kind of going to draw a line around them, but I think I'm not, actually. Just because of this, you know, this is actually like the horse in the background right here, and there's a bush behind him, so it's a weird shape. And I don't know. If I draw the line, I'm going to cut down into that and make that a even more bizarre shape. I think I'm just going to leave it like that. I'm going to put some white paint on it, though. But anyway, the thing sold, like, immediately, and I was just like, what the heck? I don't get it. And it sold to a guy who I'd never seen before. Just a sec. Okay, I'm back. But anyway, what I was talking about with that auction is it sold to a guy I'd never seen before, and I was kind of like, didn't know where it came from. And he never bought anything else from me. And it was just like, in that situation, and I know this because later I relisted that card as a print, and it wasn't a big print seller. It never sell off my site, but every now and then I'd sell another one on eBay. And I don't know how many prints I ended up selling of that card. I mean, maybe 10 or 12 or something. But to me, like, that's like a huge success for an obscure thing like that, you know? And what that was it was like, it's a guy that's into the Lone Ranger, which, I mean, yeah, you guys probably already guessed it, but, you know, it's that guy, he's into the Lone Ranger, he's on eBay, he buys that kind of stuff, and he bought that card. And the same thing, I think, goes with, like, the Snake Plissken stuff, you know, they were never sketch cards, never sketch card guys buying that stuff. It was always just, you know, random guy, number whoever, that never seen before, and then you never see him again. And man, it's like I totally had a point when I was telling this whole story. I kind of forgot what it was now. I guess it's just like you just don't know where the traffic comes from. And I don't know. That helps you kind of understand it, being an eBay affiliate. Another thing, I just thought I'd throw some tips out here, as long as it's on my mind. Another good way to help you figure out where your traffic's coming from on anything, this doesn't even matter, on eBay auctions or anything, it's like anything you do that you where you're like, I don't understand where people are coming from or who's clicking or whatever. And it is, you know, it's like you can get caught up in that stuff too much, but it's also, it helps. If you understand that a lot of traffic is coming from a certain place, you can push more stuff there. And you can also drop the stuff where nothing's coming from, you know. And like, you know, the stuff that just doesn't help you at all, you can just get it out of your life and, you know, open up your time to the stuff that is going to help. But what I was going to say, though, is, and this really works well with that eBay affiliate program, is you can go to, and there's a couple different sites, but it's basically like the short URL sites, and I use the Google short URL one. You just do a search for it, you'll find it. And you know, it just takes a huge gigantic link and shortens it down. And I originally started doing that because those eBay affiliate links are freaking, you know, a monster, gigantic, ugly, huge thing. And I didn't want to be posting those because that just looks like, you know, a big scam link or something, you know. So I'd go to Google and they'd give me a nice short link. And, but the beauty of that is that Google tracks those links for you. So you can sit there and go back in to those. And if you sign up for that site, you go back in and it has all your links you ever made in there. And it's got your stats on those links. So it's like, you know, if I went in now, I could see, you know, how many people came from Facebook into that that auction, how many people came from, you know, DeviantArt into that auction, all that kind of stuff. And, you know, it's like if you want to make different links or different things, you can really drill it down tight to figure that stuff out. I don't really bother with that. I usually just do one link and then post it all over the place to just see, just to watch and just see what's sending people there and what's not and all that kind of thing. And it's not all about links and stuff too. I don't want to be also cold-blooded about it, but there's part of it that's about selling, so you may as well be good at it. And then there's the other part, which is all about the art, and actually there's the third part, which, you know, I've kind of like started to sort of understand, is it's like there's this whole, I don't know, like, how do I say it? It's like a social part in a way. I mean, but it's more than just social. It's like this cool thing where you're making all these friends online too, you know. And it's like all these people are, I mean, just the whole thing of doing these videos, and now that, you know, there's other people trying to do the eBay thing, there's other people trying to figure out other stuff. And I just think it's so cool because it's like, you know, the whole reason I started this was to get out of my freaking job and do what I wanted, and the more people that, you know, can look at what I'm doing and then take that and let hopefully help them figure out their own thing, you know, whether it's eBay or something else, comics or whatever, that to me, that's awesome, because that's what we're all going for, you know. Or at least I don't know if we're all going for it, but I think that, you know, it's something to go for, maybe, I don't know. Is that all I had to say about that? I think so. I think I'm going to wrap this video up semi-quick today. Just because it is so freaking hot today, and I'm getting cooked, and I want to turn the fan back on, so. I think it looks pretty good. Be on eBay later. And, so thanks everybody, and thanks everybody who shared that Boba Fett piece. I really appreciate that, and, I don't know. Go join ArtCasters if you think about it, and, I don't know. That's it. See ya.